So the computer's set the descent with idle power, flight idle at 2,300 feet per minute to hold 315 knots. So if I disable this by pressing flight vertical speed change, 2,400, it just continues with what was set, with what the plane was initially at. So now I have control. I'll just put it at 2,300 there. I'm just going through 20,000 feet. I shall ding two times for the descent. And don't forget, we're passing 18,000 shortly, so we should be going over to a regional pressure altitude, which will, for the simulation, be the same 29.92, but it could be something different, and we would have to set that difference. So 800 to go. And you'll see we'll be halfway. Oh, the green arc just disappeared there, but we'll be about halfway when we reach 13,000 on the way to VPass. There we are. And our approach is over here. Just approaching 18,000 now, and over to regional. So this could be, for example, 30.05. So we're flying directly to VBAS. So what I'm going to do is press hold. In fact, I'll line up the heading indicator like I should be doing. 182 for the heading. So LNAV is now off, and we're on heading select of 182. That's going to fly directly to VBAS because we're on the magenta line. Now what I want to do is bring up the intercept route. D100W, I believe, is the missed approach. Yes. So this waypoint floating in space here is where we would be going for a missed approach to re-intercept the approach. 2,000 feet to go for 13,000. I'll just increase that to 11. Or produce, should I say. Now, what I want to show you is page 1. I'm going to put the beginning of the see if I can organise these screens a bit better for you so you can see like this. I'm just going to put the first waypoint of the approach, which is the outermost here, to the top. And there's a direct line to it. And I'm going to execute that. So the VBAS is going to disappear. And if I press LNAV, that will now turn right and fly directly to that waypoint. We don't want that to happen, of course. But if I press it again and reselect it, I have a chance, I have an opportunity to enter my own intercept course. So if we just imagine now that we're flying 180 south, north is 360 in this direction, west is 270 in this direction, and the runway is 310, which is correct, right? 270, 280, 290, 300, 310, and that's this direction. So we want to intercept this at, let's just say, so 310, 300, 290, 280. I think that 280 would be a nice intercept. Let's say 285. And you see this line here, this is our own intercept. If I execute that, I'm all the time, by the way, I am watching our altitude and speed to make sure that the engines aren't playing up. So you can now see that we have our own intercept line for the approach. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow that. I'm going to fly into this, and I'm going to turn, and I'm going to use this as my intercept path. And if I want, I can change it when I want. So I could activate it again now. And 210, because that's where we are. But it was 285, so let's say 295, or 290, just 5 degrees extra. See, it's just a little bit more acute there. So I'll execute that. I've added 5 degrees, and that now changes to 5. Nose levelling up at 11,000. I'm going to take the opportunity of this increase in nose up attitude, where the power would be increasing, because it will have to maintain 315 knots. I'm going to take this opportunity to reduce the speed now to 280 knots. too fast. The simulator doesn't like that. And I'm going to maintain this heading for the time being. Now there's some hills here, so I want to stay above those. I'll increase the bank level because we'll be doing some steep turns later. Just overflying Granada here. You can see the airport over here. So we're at 11,000, we have a nice gentle speed. I'm going to start to see the right turn now to get a bit closer to the airport, down to 200. You can see the, you can hear the power and see the power increasing because we're turning, so our drag has increased, so overcome that drag. I shall put the outboard landing lights on, and I'm just going to lower the lights in the cockpit here, as would happen in the real world. So we're on a nice intercept heading for Malaga. Okay, so if I bring your attention to the init ref page, this is automatically on approach ref. So we want a landing with 30 degrees of flaps, which gives us 153 knots as a reference speed. That will pop up over here. So I select it into the scratch pad and enter it into the box, 153, and that will also give us our flap schedule for when to extend the flaps on the approach. Because we entered our intercept path, this is very, very useful to help us judge where we should turn to have a nice intercept. And if we just go back to the descent, when to descent thing I taught you last time, we have 40 miles to go till this waypoint, and we're 11,000 feet, so if we multiply 11 by 3, that's 33,000 feet. So let's just say at 35 we can start descending down to say 4,000 initially. I'll set 4,000 in the window, and I'll just get ready to descend there in a moment. If you're wondering what this is just the recommended descent path. This is when it says we should start descending, and you'll notice that that's almost the same as when I said. So that should be in the middle, generally speaking, but that's mainly for the vertical navigation control, so you can monitor it. But I'm saying descend about now, and that will almost be in the middle also. So this method is very, very accurate. Now we're descending below 10,000, so we'll bring back the speed to our flap-up speed, 234. Let the speed die back there. Should be passing 250 knots at about 10,000, so there's no worry there. So 250 knots, and we're just 200 feet above 10,000, so that's good. Now the approach checklist, we've got seatbelts on, flight door locked, auto brakes are on, we'll put level 2 because the runway is not very, very long. And then smoking is on. Spoilers are armed. And we'll put the outboard landing, the inboard landing lights on too. Approaching our first flap setting. We're going to let the speed bleed off as well, so we might be able to get back to about 225 knots there, just to save any big engine increases. We'll see what naturally balances out. Very shortly we'll be starting the right turn. We'll just set 225 there, nice round number. I'll just reduce the bank limit so we don't turn too soon, but we'll make a right turn now heading 270. It looks like we can increase the bank a bit more. And we'll actually continue the turn to intercept this line, which was 290, I believe. So we're 17 miles from the outermost waypoint. Don't think that that's 17 miles from the runway. From the runway we are 25, so the ILS has just been auto-tuned and the runway heading is 314. Our altitude is okay. This is telling us that we're just about 600 feet too high or so, but it's nothing serious at all. So the airport's just over here somewhere. And again, the autopilot will be landing, and I'll take over the auto throttle at around 1,000 feet. It's a lot more challenging at night time because you have to rely absolutely on all the instruments. You can't really forget anything. Because we're at 4,000 feet, we will be at 4,000 feet, and the runway is 20 miles. If we multiply 4 by 3, that's 12. So we can be around 12 nautical miles when we're at 4,000 feet to begin our final approach descent. So we're not too high or too low, everything's fine. And the glide slope needle, there you go, we're just underneath the needle, it's perfect. You always want to intercept a glide slope from below, never above. So I'm very happy with that. I'm going to press lock here, which is now armed, the localizer intercept. So when this diamond here, which is the runway center line, the actual localizer, starts to move across and becomes active, the aircraft will automatically turn to intercept. If I pressed LNAV, the aeroplane would follow the magenta line. But that was just a demonstration, but we're pretty much on that. I'm quite happy with that. So we are descending to 4,000. If I reduce the rate of descent so we don't get too low from the glide slope, we can then combine the intercept with the actual glide path. So I can press approach and it will take over the localizer and the descent. So that will be a very smart intercept.